Hey you guys, this is Ruben React. So now I'm gonna make my reaction to Iceland. Which Iceland is interesting because 2019 they had Atari, which was a song that personally I didn't care about at all. It was a song that I was like, yeah, not for me. I was, how do you say, on, well, when you have no opinion, I was like neutral, like Switzerland about it. I'm kidding. We always joke about Switzerland. Yeah, I was neutral about it. And then I found that, what was the other song? In 2021 and 2020 they had Daddy. I did not like a song of 2020. I did like a song of 2021 a lot. And he became fourth with it, even though he did not perform because of two members of the band having COVID. Which is normal, like if you're a band and you spend a lot of time, then you're almost sure that one of them is gonna get COVID. So. I don't know why they didn't. Did they all have separate rooms? Like, let me know the information about that. I don't know how it worked, but like, I don't know how only two of them get COVID. That's weird. Like, or maybe they just went wild and the other three said, no, don't do it. And the other two said, yes, we're going to do something. We're going to eat or go out or whatever. But I doubt it. I don't know how they catch it. Anyways, it's not their fault. I just want to say that that song was epic. It just gives me a lot of memories of like last year. Yeah, that song was great. It's not the kind of artist I would like listen to a lot. Because after a while I find his sound is always a bit similar. So I'm curious what they sent this year. Because after rock and then a kind of like geek guy, you know. What are they gonna send this year? I know there was a final. Okay. What? Þreytin þungum af en sorgar sárum þá sem laða brennur sem bár. Wow. Ykkur í leyni lindar má þeir. This is good. You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of Calm After the Storm, the Netherlands 2014, is also reminds me of Hanson, you remember from the 90s? You know, the three brothers that were having a lot of hits. People from my age will remember. That was like a big part of the 90s, that song. And also I had their CD, it was very good music. A bit this kind of, you know, sister-brother religious thing. And then it reminds me also of something else, but I forgot what I wanted to say. But I get those vibes. Yeah, it's a female version of Hanson. It's very peaceful. Like countryside ladies from Iceland. Whoa! I don't know what to say. I don't really have the words. I don't know how to express myself. Like, this is good, but also at the same time, it's a bit like unexpected. So I don't know what to think. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to think. If I can be honest, I really like the chorus, and it's very peaceful. It's very, the kind of song you put before bed. Is that good for Eurovision? That's another story. I always like to be honest in my reactions because, first of all, I'm Dutch, so that's legendary. And we are known for that. We are very direct. We always say what we think and what we feel. Not all Dutch people, but I do. And I use it as an excuse. Now, it's really in our culture. And some people consider that rude. That's just our culture. If you don't like it, too bad for you. So if I say something that is maybe offensive for you, then don't take it as something offensive. And remember that it's just your perception. This is, and don't take everything so seriously, because I'm just one guy making a reaction. And if you don't like it, go and watch somebody else. That's what I want to say in my every video, but then I'm like, yeah, that's gonna be boring. So I just say it now, in case some of you guys are on your keyboards, you know, saying, you cannot say this, you cannot say that, I can say whatever I want. We live in a democracy, freedom of speech, very important. So I think people in Iceland understand that. This really reminds me of like three ladies from the countryside in Iceland. I have seen some documentaries about Iceland. I know they're very connected to nature. I've met people from Iceland. They're very friendly. And I remember I met a girl from Iceland. She was always having a bottle of water with like a lot of like plants and berries from the nature. And I said, how did you get that? Because we were in Holland. And she said, well, I just went outside in the nature and I find a lot of things. And she made this every day. And I was like, wow, people in Iceland must be very connected to nature. So I discovered that. And I discovered that you like to go to festivals and all this stuff. And that Norwegian and Swedish people like to make fun of you because you're always like, yeah, that you're all like a small country and you're all brothers and sisters in some way. So I know quite some a bit about Iceland. It's funny how they went, how they go from rock cool, trying to impress, to like a nerdy geek, to like something very typical Icelandic. So that's what I like. And they went with country. So chapeau, good job, Iceland. I like this. It's country folk. I like this song. It gives me, I don't know, it makes me calm. You see what I mean? It's very calm. Okay, this is the calm after the storm part. They stole that a bit, but that's okay. No, what I want to say is they will be maybe the Portugal of this year, or maybe the Netherlands of 2014. They will be this kind of country that nobody will expect them to do well, and they will end up in the top five, you know? That's what I have the feeling with this kind of song. Because why would it win the national final? I know that there was a lot of drama also, because I follow all national finals. Even if I did the final of Sweden, I know what other countries, what happened. So I know that some people were not happy also. Same with Portugal also, I believe. But yeah, I was doing Sweden that evening. And I heard people in the comments saying this song went for Iceland. And some people said, oh no, I wanted the other one. So I guess that like the opinions are divided. But me as a foreigner who did not watch any of the national final of Iceland, I find this very interesting. And I find this a good entry that I think can do surprisingly well. Like one of those entries, you don't see them coming and suddenly they're like in the top 10 or the top 5, you know, one of those. That's a good song. I like it. I like it a lot. This will be one of those songs where people will either say, we like it. Oh, by the way, they're promoting Lithuania. It's a bit also this kind of song. So it all depends if they have competition, similar kind of song. There is Lithuania, as we see here. Or if people are like in the mood for this kind of song. It all depends on the mood of people. Because I think in the bubble, people will not really care about this. So I think people who watch this on TV, they will have a nice, like, you know, after all those bops and all those, how do you say, power ballads and ballads, they will want something calm in between. There's always one of those songs in Eurovision. Last year it was Portugal, and in 2019 it was another song, I don't remember, but Like it was, for example, which was its song? Latvia, I think. And yeah, this could do very well. Depending if Lithuania goes also to the final, if then both of them go to the final, or if they're in the same semi-final, then maybe they will battle against each other for the one song that is like this. Because I see for now only two songs like this. Yeah, my opinion about it is that it's a good choice and that I think that it's gonna go to the final, and I think that it will do surprisingly well. Then at the same time, it will have to battle Lithuania if they're in the same semi-final. If they're not, then in the final, then they will have a kind of competition between which one of those will be like the most popular in that genre, let's say. But it's a different genre. I know Lithuania is not completely the same, but still it's the only one that is quite similar. So for the calm songs this year, this is one of the best ones. And I think after this I'm gonna do Lithuania, because I remember that I made a reaction to it, but I don't remember if it's in my videos or if I just by accident never uploaded it. So I will have to look before I make the reaction if I still have it in my videos, because I remember I made a reaction to that. Anyway, sorry, that's all what's going in my life. So this is about Iceland. Sister, okay, I understand that part, but I don't understand the title. Með hækkandi sól. I have no idea what that means. For Iceland, good choice. Yeah. Tell me what you think. Don't forget to subscribe. Be yourself. Be nice to yourself and each other. Don't forget to always be yourself and be nice to yourself and each other. And to always subscribe and to always leave a like, because it helps in the algorithm and it helps my algorithm. And leave comments also what you think, what you feel, if you agree with me or not. And that's all gonna be for me. I give this song 8 out of 10 on the performance and the video. And I think they're gonna change it a bit, but I think they should keep it simple like this, because if you make it too, you know, colorful and too, yeah, that's not good. It also reminds me of another song a bit. Mostly Calm After the Storm. Yeah, mostly Calm After the Storm. Also a little bit Latvia in 2019, that where are you? You know that song? Look it up, Latvia 2019. I made a reaction to it too. And a little bit maybe, yeah, those kind of songs, but mostly Calm After the Storm and the female version of Hansen. I repeat again, for the people from my age, they're gonna laugh. Like in Sweden, the national final, there was also one guy that had that same haircut as the guy from the Backstreet Boys. And I was joking with people in my chat. You can watch my live stream, in my live streams, of Sweden, France, Norway, Finland, and Moldova. You can watch all those live streams. And France, I was joking saying that that kid really looked like, in the comments people were saying, this is the most Swedish kid looking ever. And other people saying, well, it's just looked like a general Swedish guy with the same haircut. But then I was saying to my chat, this guy looks like Nick Carter, like a copy of Nick Carter. Was even having like 90s clothes, 90s look. They really went for that on purpose, even the haircut and everything. So from the Backstreet Boys, so all you guys, my generation, and Hanson and all this kind of songs from that generation will understand what I'm saying. Or his little brother Aaron Carter, who had a small career too. And we were joking about that, I remember. So yeah, I get so much nostalgia, like Hanson, Aaron Carter, Nick Carter. Was even talking with Marion just about Hobie, that song from, you know, the kid from the son of what was his name, David Hasselhoff. He had a little bit of career too, like Hobie. So yeah, it's funny how like the 90s had such a big influence musically on me, and that I still remember so much. So you guys, that's all gonna be for me. I wish you a great day, and yeah, let me know if you agree or not. Again, subscribe, comment, and like, and wishing you a great day. Hartet bra, doei doei, arrivederci, au revoir, hasta luego, and tusen takk, and I guess somewhere in between there is an Icelandic version of saying bye-bye, but for now I just say bye-bye. Okay, doei doei.